Remember when not using the resistance bands, you want to really focus your attention on the tenseness of the muscle, keeping the muscle tight, really tightening that muscle and keeping complete control of both the movements, up and down. So let's get started. We're gonna do a bicep curl. So you're gonna step on your resistance band in the center where you can feel the even tension. And palms facing down, curl up, one, two, three, and down, one, two, three. One, two, three, two. Four. Remember the concentration on keeping the muscles tense.
Five.
Six. You can feel that, can't you? Seven. Keep your elbows into your sides. Eight. Let's do two more. This isn't what you want. You don't want it out here. You want your elbows in here. Nine. One more. Ten. All right, so what we're simply going to do is flip. So your palms are going to face the ceiling, okay? Same exercise. If you're feeling more comfortable with both of your feet on the band, by all means, do it. If this is too easy for you, you just make the band shorter and the tension gets harder. You see that? So palms up, and we're gonna do the same. Let me back up. I feel like I'm not in the frame here. Okay. Ready? 10. 1. 2. 3. Four, elbows in, five, six, seven, three more, eight, full control, nice easy movements, nine, last one, 10. Excellent. So now, similar exercise. This is just going to be a hammer curl where your palms will face your thighs. Like you're throwing a punch. Boom, right? So we're gonna step on our bands. Palms facing your thighs or facing your body. Elbows in. We're gonna bring your fists to your shoulders. One. Two. Three. Remember, if you're not using the bands, you really need to use your imagination with the concentration on keeping those muscles tense and tight. What is that, seven? Let's do three more. Three, two, last one, one. Excellent. All right, so now what are we gonna do? We're gonna do a little bit of shoulder. We're gonna do a bicep curl into a shoulder press. So we're going to step on our bands. Make sure our tension is even on both sides. I'm gonna back up. I don't know why I'm not in the frame today. Very strange. Okay. We're gonna do bicep curl. Flip your palms forward.
Shoulder press.
One. And let it out.
Two.
Really concentrate on the controlled movement.
3.
Elbows in.
6. Seven.
If you can't go all the way up with that band, and this is all you can do, that's okay. 8. That's what resistance bands are really great for. Showing you your limits and then allowing you to press them.
That's 10. There you go, guys. Okay.
Now we're going to do a bicep curl to a lat raise. You may find the lat raises to be a bit difficult. So remember, wherever the tension is that you feel you can't go past, just a little bit more, and there's your limit, okay? So we're going to do, again, bicep curl, down, palms facing your thighs, out. Got it? That's 1, 2. Great for sexy shoulders.
6.
Last one.
10.
Woo! Feeling that. All right, so we're gonna do a little forearm work. This may seem silly, but it's pretty effective. I'm going to add a little bit of a punch to this, and I'm going to use one of the these resistance bands. I'm gonna use the medium resistance band. You see these guys? Going to put this around my ankles. I can use the light one. I think I probably should because I stretched out the light one. This one's not stretched out yet. But it is what it is, right? Right above your knees. Right where you can feel the pull, about shoulder width apart. Squat. Put your knees, your elbows on your knees, palms facing up. We're going to really just focus on the muscle contraction. See, I'm in a squat position. You see this? Focus on the muscle contraction, and we're going to work forearms. So you simply bend your wrists in, focusing on the muscle contraction, and out. 1. Keeping that squat position. 2. 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Try to focus on having your weight back into your heels. It's really easy to push forward in that. I felt myself doing it just now. So now, with our palms facing down, same thing. Squat position, palms facing down. We're gonna do the same. 1, 2, 3,
4. 5. 6. 7.
3 more. Hold it. You got it.
3. 2.
Last one.
1.
Feel that burn. Ba-da-ba-da. Woo woo! All right, moving right into triceps, guys. We got 3 more exercises, all tricep related. Then we're good to go. Okay, wanna do some kickbacks? You're like, yeah, whatever. Whatever you say. So we're going to step on the band in the center, just as before, in a lunge position. Somewhat of a lunge position, just get comfortable, guys. It's cool. And we're gonna do palms facing the back of us. Right? And we're simply going to keep your elbows in. The only thing that moves is the bottom half of your arm. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3. Focus on keeping those elbows in and squeezing the muscle at the top. 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, last one, 10. Okay, cool. Now we're gonna do hammers. Same idea. Palms facing in like you're throwing the punch. We're gonna step on the band in a little bit of a lunge position. Don't let your knee go above your toes. We need to remember that rule, right? Keep your elbows in. Only the bottom half of your arms move. And that's it. 1, 2, 3. You're only going to feel a bit of a tension right at the top. 4, depending on the length of your band. 5. Just squeeze it. 6. Overhead extensions. Now let me show you. They're very, very effective with no weight. You put your hands in like a praying position, just like this, above your head. Like you're a shark. You go down and then squeeze at the top. Focusing on the muscle contraction, that's 2. Really squeezing at the top, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's do 3 more. 8, 9. Last one. 10. Okay. So that's it, y'all. And I will catch y'all. Move more moments on the fit side.